Jesus team, we are in page number three. The Jesus team is also written continuation of what we are doing. As we are going to Jesus team, I need us to call what we call today the Jesus team topic will be the helper. The helper. Jesus is your helper. And Jesus has repositioned every one of us to operate in the gift of the Holy Spirit. Let's go straight right now to the book of Acts of the Apostles, chapter 2, verse 1. The Bible talks about when the day of the Pentecost come, that they were all with one accord in one place. But that is not where we are going. What we are going at Jesus Christ, for you to be the thief, that we understand the mysteries of the kingdom, it is very, very, very important that you have the Holy Spirit. Somebody say the Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit.
Because the Holy Spirit will give you the mind of Christ. I just want us to quickly look at what does the Holy Spirit does when you have the Holy Spirit. The book of John, we are in page 3 of Jesus' King, the mysteries of the kingdom. No church can exist without the Holy Spirit. Hello? If you don't have the Holy Spirit, you cannot please God. And Satan hated the present generation with perfect hatred. Hello? Hello? But God wants us to come and John chapter number 14.
Can you hold it for me? Thank you. Let's come to the book of John. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory be to God. John chapter number 1. I want us to continue what the Holy Spirit says. What did Jesus Christ say? Who is our helper? And that helper is the Holy
Spirit.
Holy Spirit. I want us to know when you have the Holy Spirit, in chapter 14 of John,
Holy Spirit, what does it do? You can never even be a Jesus team without the Holy Spirit. Because the Spirit that walked in Jesus is holy. And do you know that if all of us live like Jesus, the church will be so full. Because it will be full of love. It will be full of joy. It's full of forgiveness. But nowadays, how many churches are full of bitterness, resentment, anger, cause? I told you my experience back in the United Kingdom. I finished ministry, I did not know one head pastor. She said, please, when you pray, woman of God, I know God answer your prayer. And she gave me the list of church members I need to curse. List. There are some, the husband is there, the wife is there. She said, mom, they have done me a lot of evil. The ones that sleep and not wake up. The ones that wake up playing and crying. The man of God is above 70. He's talking to me and was crying.
Oh,
I bet the church is not in church to behave well. Don't post things to the pastor. What did I say? When I was inside the cabin, when I came down, she went on the stone. I said, mom, I've heard about you. I'm looking forward to seeing you. I said, stand up. I said, please, I'm ready to listen to you. And I'm praying. They stand up. She loves to God. And when he gave me the list, I said, this time you are saying we all have them. We can't pray that they should sleep. He said they should move from sleep to. And he was crying. I said, I know, Daddy, you felt altered. But don't let us do it that way. I said, I don't know them, but I'm pleading on their behalf. Don't let them tie them. Don't let us. I said, please, if you use collecting anointing, and tie them. I said, no. And the danger of it, if you have a call anointing on a woman of God who calls upon you, you need another name greater than Jesus to break it. And there is no another name.
You are gone forever.
That is the danger. There is no what? There is no another. I said, Daddy, I understand the principle. Please, let's pray for God to give them the spirit of repentance. Let's slip and a contact to let them know that the pastor is in pain and they should be concerned. And give daddy to grace to let his sister to cry. Glory be to us. I entered the plane and deleted the number. I said, God, I need pastor who will encourage me. I need pastor who will say, please, if your member offend you, forgive them. I don't need you. I said, if I add this in my list, I can also join him one day. I said, no, because show me your friend. It's true. I was so, because it was shocked, I tried to be smart. I said, no, we can't do that. If I keep on hanging on around him, one day I said, I don't want this handle. If any man or woman of God that do that, you yourself will end up in hell. And I don't want to carry this Bible. The devil will be rebuking. I don't want to be his neighbor in hell. Anybody that becomes the neighbor of Satan in hellfire, it can never be our apostle. But he takes the Holy Spirit inside of me. Immediately as he's talking, the Holy Spirit says, No. Do you know that there are some people they are even talking to you on the phone? Do you know they are talking to you? Say, no, I'm not going to join you. No, because you have the Spirit of God inside of you. If you have the Spirit, nobody can call you and initiate you to anger. Somebody like, for nothing to you, any him. I say, you have a lot of emotion. For me to you, me to never. Somebody tell me, I'm not doing you. I talk to my neighbor. You to me, and me to you. You to never go. I say, God, even if in Europe, we don't have any never. People of God, the Holy Spirit is a spirit of love. I just pray that God will fill this church. God will fill your life with the spirit of love, with the spirit of joy, with the spirit of let's go. You know that if God will allow people that you have offended to bring down their list, you will run away. I'm serious. You know that we can even offend people without knowing.
Yes.
And that person is just crying, saying, God, this is about me. And you are saying, meanwhile, you believe you are the most holy. None of us is holy. But the Holy Spirit will help us to embrace. Even though that it is in Europe that I know that you can come to church and give money. You're a Christian, God have mercy on you. Somebody say, they can come to church, they can make up and do everything. And that's what for me, I will not talk. Hey, even something did Jesus come. And if Jesus comes, he will be asking to settle this between two of you. When he comes on your way to hell, it's better you repent. Then I'm talking about the whole. When he comes, who does the Holy Spirit come? Let's go to John chapter 14. John 14, from verses number 16. He says, and I will pray the Father. Are you there? John 14, 16. Are you there? He said, and I will pray the Father. This Jesus stands for I. Pray. That is our oxygen. Somebody say oxygen. People know when you can pray, you can overcome every problem. The difference between church members and the pastor is God. We spend quality time before. That is that way. When I'm looking at you, I can know your problem. Not when I know what to do for you to come out. If you can pray, you can come out. Every problem in your life has an expiry date. That is it. They don't come to stay. Then your character can prolong them. You know the problem of Israel, they are supposed to work in the wilderness for 40. But because of their own belief, because of doubt, the 40 days become, and when our prayer is becoming, answer is becoming long, the heart becomes sick, the hope becomes divine, the faith, you hear somebody that says, Jesus is my Lord. Even Jesus says, I will go to church. I go last week now. I've been going there, not knowing that God will surely visit you. The prayer, I want you to know that prayer is also the master key. He said, I will pray the Father. Father, yes, thanks for God. And he shall give you another
comforter.
You will let your heart get broke. When you are alone, you need this comforter. Hello? This comforter, when nobody is with you, I cannot promise, I can't promise that I can follow all of you all now. Hello? I can't promise. But this Holy Ghost is a comforter. If you ask your heart, every day, you stand alone, think, and start crying. You need the comforter. May the comforter enter your life. And the comforter is to comfort you. It's to console you. He will give you hope.
Oh, yes.
He will tell you that he's at work in your life. Yes. He does not only give you comfort, he gives you everything we read. It's a mystery in the kingdom. You can never be a Jesus teaching without being a comforter. How many people in life, they are bitter themselves? They are bitter. If you see somebody laughing, you know that because you are laughing and happy, they get angry. Have you seen people like that? They tell you, what's wrong with you? Why are you always laughing? So it is so important you are not the comforter, that he may abide with you forever. 17. Even the spirit of truth. Verse 17, please. Even the spirit of truth. It means when you have this spirit, anywhere you are, you will say the truth. It's the spirit of God. You don't say the word. You are transparent. You are doing what?
Transparent.
You are transparent. You can say the truth. And I was speaking to my children. When I look at my growing, I can remember when I was 10 years, 15, 20, 25, 27, when I was still with my parents, I never take 1 cent more than what I need in the school. Actually, I pity them. They were pastors. You know, pastor in Nigeria. Sorry to say, no much. And so by the time the pastor go up and down to give me, I make sure I did not get one. If the change remains in my hand, I will come back and say, Daddy, mommy, take spirit of truth. And I look back, every prayer they pray for me. Hello? Every prayer they pray. If you walk in the spirit of truth, you put yourself under what we call the divine blessing of the Lord. When I look back, all those prayers come to me. Come to reality. So, people of God, it's a spirit of truth. When you are told, you can take truth. If at the time you can compromise, you need this spirit. Hello? If at the time when church people is there, you can behave only. And when they are not there, you can change time. You know what we call change time? Somebody say, I attended one of your birthday of one of our sisters. She just come on here, we need you to open this something. I came. After 10 minutes, mom, when are you going? I'm talking live. I said, but on Sunday, you waited for me for 2 hours to start your bed. Mom, we have finished the prayer. When are you going? You know how much I said, sister, but you have been waiting for me. And you said, without me, you won't start the presenter. You have prayed. We are not God has moved. Holy Spirit, tell me there's a secret. Okay. And I now call one. I said, look, I just said, can I meet you in the car? I said, please, take the video of everything that happened and just send it to me. Let's go next car. It's okay. How? 8 hours later, the video comes. Excuse me, the dress changed. The atmosphere changed. The kind of music. Leg up. The blouse is half naked. I said, okay, now I know why she's asking me. Spirit of the truth. Can I ask, how far can you say the truth? How? When you say you stand for Jesus now, we are having Jesus' team. Can you stand with him? Pastor Florence said something. He said, let somebody come and bring God now. It will never happen with Jesus. If you are for Jesus, come here, we want to kill you. If you are not for Jesus, find your way out and go. Hello? I tell you, that never happened with Germany. May there be a divine protection upon the Christian faith. But, can I ask you, some of us, if we are really truthful, we will see the power of God in our life and we see. Sometimes, we are the ignorances to our own life. Sometimes we are the one entering the move of God. Sometimes we are the one that will not allow the flow. See, God is so powerful. How powerful God will be in your life, you will determine it. You will do what?
Determine.
Do you know that Jesus Christ, even in his own place, the Bible says he was anointed, going to God, being good, but he was limited. Even in his own truth, in your working place, truth. When you are told truth, you get to supermarket and they say, do not remove the Don't remove the material from the package unless you buy it. But you know, nobody said, look at the corner for me, let me check, and you remove this. And you tell, and when you check, you don't even, I'm not even faithful enough, so you don't drop it and go. How truthful can you be? The spirit of truth. I pray may God listen to your life. The Bible talks about the spirit. Whom the world can not it mean? When you are looking for the truth, there's no truth in the world. But can this truth, God wants every one of us to operate in this truth, because he sees him not. Neither knoweth him, but ye know him, for he shall dwell with you and shall be in you. Somebody, the spirit of truth.
Spirit of truth.
Enter my life.
Enter my
dwell
life.
Dwell in me.
Dwell in me.
Let where you are. I'm begging you to say the truth. 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 Don't camouflage. It is very important. If I will not leave you comfortless, I will come to you. Let's look for the same chapter. The same chapter before we call it here for Jesus' sake. The same chapter, verse 26. The same chapter, I say, but the comforter, and that comforter is who? When you say the word the comforter, it's also a defender. He will defend you. This spirit is a fighter. Fight for you. This spirit is an armor. This spirit, when the enemy can go up against you, you know what the spirit of the Lord does? You will allow them to start fighting themselves. Hello? When the spirit of the Lord is inside of you, you are not ordinary. You are not what? There are some things when you are saying, you know, you cannot be part of. I asked my chair, I said, since you have known me as your mom, have you seen somebody call any black woman, step in and say she's my friend to come and talk with you? They say never. Why? I didn't hate people. But when you have the spirit of truth, you walk according to the direction of the Holy Spirit. You don't walk according to what people say. You don't even walk to please people. If you are not to please people, you know there are people, but pastor please us. If you are just pastor please us, you miss it. Please God. I tell people, in this job, whatever you cannot do, but whatever you want, you don't want God to see, don't do it. Don't look, pastor is there now. Most times, the way people behave only. And when I heard that the back what happened, I said, God, is it the same? If I have just one terminology in my life, anywhere I cannot say the truth, you can't find me here. Any situation where the truth cannot prevail, I know it's a dangerous soul for me. And if Jesus Christ is the truth, the youth that are here can encourage you to be truthful. And for you to be fruitful, you must set boundaries around your life. Have godly boundaries around your life. Adults in your mouth have boundaries. You, and I tell you one of the boundaries I have, when I'm hungry, I will talk. When I'm hungry, I will know what? And now that anger, just let it be inside of you. After 10 minutes, 20 minutes, 15 minutes, Holy Spirit, help me to bring out this anger. Holy Spirit, you want me to help you? I will help you. Just keep quiet. The first day, say, keep quiet. The second day, keep quiet. The third day, keep quiet. Before you realize, it will go. You must have boundaries in your mouth. Hello? Have boundaries. I see people, their mouth is like a tap water. Dangerous. I've seen people die because of the word of their mouth.
Yeah.
Son's daughter, he saw his husband, the king, dancing before the ark. He said, hey, mm-hmm. And you call yourself king. And you are half naked, shame. And what happened? She was the only one named by in the Bible. Boundaries in your mouth, even in your eyes, set what? When you are on the social media, set boundaries. There are some things when you watch it, if never you are watching that softly, your spirit is already polluted. Evil dream is already sure. The masculine to run ahead of you is already waiting. They don't want you to sleep or pick up their job. Set boundaries. Set boundaries. Set control. Even in your clothes, set boundaries. The purpose of clothes is to cover nakedness. Any clothes you wear, they are seeing your brand. You are not wearing clothes. Wear clothes. Set boundaries. Even in your friendship. Set what? Not everybody. I see some. Hey, pastor, she's from my mother's tribe. We speak the same. I said, that's good. And they are going up and down. 2 weeks later, oh, that woman is so true. She's evil. Somebody can speak your mother's language. That does not say she must be your friend. You must be at peace with everybody. The friendship is by God. Set boundaries. Finally, when the Spirit of the Holy Ghost comes, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things. Holy Spirit is a teacher of all
things.
He knows your problem. He will teach you how to come out of it. He will correct you. He will teach you patience. He will teach you joy. He will teach you faith. He will teach you fear. He will tell you what is supposed to be quiet. Hello? Somebody is talking to the Holy Spirit. They just keep quiet. He said, you, Holy Spirit, just keep quiet. You. And after you say, oh, God blessing you, you go. And you never realize that you are not the one that takes. Oh, sister, I have already insulted you. I am very sorry for what I've done. Holy Spirit will help you. I will call it, it will help you to get balance. Some of us spiritually will stand with one leg. Can I ask you, how long can I stand with one leg? Can I go downstairs with one leg? God wants you to get balance. Stand up, let me pray for you. Father, I am praying for your church. God bless you, Pastor. The Lord will honor you. Father, I am praying for your church.
Amen.
I ask for the Spirit of truth.
Amen.
People that need to be comforted. People that are going through pain and challenges. Let your power touch
them. Amen.
People that are going through certain difficulties. Let the Spirit of the truth enter their life and swallow everything that cannot be done. Let your life be saved. Let your glory be seen. In Jesus' name we are praying.
Amen. 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 Fire.